Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in today's session, we'll discuss about the configuration of a desktop or a laptop. So if you are buying a laptop or a desktop computer, so you need to give the configuration. That means the requirements. So the requirements of a processor or a RAM or a memory or a display or any operating system, so like that there will be some specifications. So we need to give those requirements. So that requirements we call it as a configuration. So in this configuration, so first one is mainly if you want to buy the device or a desktop or a computer, first we'll go with the desktop. So that can be of two categories. One is assembled and another one is a brand. So what is the difference between this assembled and a brand? So if you go with the brand, all the hardware components of that particular system will be of same brand. For example, if you go with a Dell, so all the components, each and every component. So I think in the previous session, we have seen what are the components available in the CPU, right? So all the components of that computer will be of the same brand. Whenever you are going with assembled, so there will be different brands. Right, so the motherboard will be of one brand, the processor will be one, and memory will be one, right? So like that the components will be of multiple brands. So we'll combine all those things in a single cabinet, and that type of desktop computer we call it as an assembled computer, right? So this brand means we know this Dell, Lenovo, Acer, like that. So these are the brands, right? So we can go with a brand or assembled, whatever it may be. So in both the cases we need to configure the system. That means we need to take care about a few things. First one is a processor. So what type of processor we require? So there are different types of processors. So i3, i5 and i7, right? i3, i5 and i7. What is the difference between all these threes? So it will be having some two cores. So core here, core means the multiple CPUs. Okay, so this complete processor itself is a CPU, and inside the CPU again it will be divided into different processing units. So if it is a two cores, so there will be two CPUs here, and if it is a four cores, so we'll be having four different processing units, right? So in order to execute multiple programs at a time, so increasing of these cores gives a multiple executions, multiple program executions, right? So the here i3 will be having the two cores, and it will be having some 4 to 8 cores, and this is also having some 4 cores. So this is the main difference. And also cache memory, right? So I think here, so this will be having some 2 MB of cache, and here we'll be having some 4 MB of cache, and here we'll be having some 8 MB of cache. So we call it a level 2 cache memory. So there are different types of cache memories. So L1, L2, L3. So this L1 cache will be residing on the memory RAM. This will be on processor, okay, and this will be on hard disk, secondary storage, right? So there are different types of cache memory, and we'll go with this cache memory which is available in this processor, and that will be of 2 MB, and here it is a 4 MB, it will be 8 MB. Here also increasing of this cache memory automatically increases the response time. Okay, so very fast, increasing this cache memory will get the response very fast. So that's the main difference of this processor, that is a processors, i3 processor, i5 processor and i7 processor. And also frequency. One more advantage is frequency. One more comparison is the frequency. That means the number of instruction cycles executed per second. This will also improve the speed, right? So this frequency will be also depends on the processor, right? This will be having some frequency, this will be having some frequency, and this will be having some frequency. And the measurement of this frequency is on in hedges, okay, gigahedges, megahedges, like that, right? So first one is a processor. We need to select the processor whether we require i3 or i5 or i7. And then the next one is RAM. So the primary memory. So increasing of the RAM will also give the, will also speed up the execution process of the system. So it will require the DDR4 4GB or 8GB, okay, or 16GB RAM. So we need to select the primary memory, that is a RAM, how much RAM we require. And memory is nothing but our secondary storage. Secondary storage means hard disk, right? Hard disk. So this can be either SDD or HDD. So solid state drive, sorry, SSD or HDD, solid state drive or hard disk drive. So when compared to the hard disk drive, this is very fast. This is very fast, and also it's an expensive, right? So we need to check, we need to get the capacity of this hard disk which we require, whether it may be 128 SSD or 1 TB of HDD. Okay, so 128 GB of SSD, right? Or 256 or 1 TB, like that. So here also we can go with the 2 TB hard disk drive. So we need to know the capacity of the hard disk which we require, right? And the next one is a graphic card. What's the importance of this graphics card? So this graphic card is used to improve the resolution of the display. So this will be mainly used for gaming programs. So if you are a very interested towards the gaming applications, then we can have this graphics card. So for gaming, better experience on gaming, right? So gaming experience. So better quality, right? And the next one is a monitor. So we need to go with the monitor. So how much length we require? So what is the size of the monitor? It is a 21 inch or a 15 inch or 24 inch. So the inch of the monitor, and also we have to go with the resolution, how much resolution that monitor will accept, right? And next one is the operating system. So most of the things we have to observe is an operating system. We know that the operating systems can be the Windows or Linux, right? So if the configuration, if you are buying the laptop or a desktop on online, you can observe here some of the devices or some of the laptops or computers will be showing as a DOS. That means if you buy that particular computer, initially there will be no operating system. So we need to install operating system externally. And for some computers you can observe it as a Windows 10, something like that. So that means if you buy that particular laptop or a desktop, initially there will be an operating system that is a Windows 10, that is a genuine version, okay? And also seeing for some computers you will be observing like Linux. So that means by default it will be a Linux operating system, the installed operating system will be the Linux. So like this you can find the three categories if you are buying the laptop or a desktop on online, right? So you can observe this one. And finally, ports. This is also very important. So how many ports available for our system? So like USB ports, how many USB ports, how many HDMI ports, right? And memory cards ports, all these things. So how many ports are available in our laptop, right? And also speed of that particular ports. If you are moving with a USB, so it will be of 2 speed and a 3 speed, right? So you can observe. You can observe that, right? So these are the things we need to concentrate before buying any computer or a laptop, right? And now I will show you the configuration of all these things where we have to find after buying the laptop or a desktop. So if you are having any personal computer or a laptop, so how can you find the configuration of that particular laptop? That means what is the processor you are using, what is the RAM, and what is the hard disk and graphics card, monitor resolutions and ports, so how many ports, and what is the operating system, mainly the operating system available in our computer, and what is the architecture, either it is a 32-bit architecture or a 64-bit architecture, and everything. So how can we know the configuration on our computer? That's I will show you on the computer, right? So let's move on to the computer.
Yeah, hello friends. So just now we have seen the configuration of the system, so what we have to focus, and now after getting the system, how to check the configuration. So just go to the Explorer. So here you will find the this PC. So just right click on this PC and go to the properties, so that you will get the information. See, if you can observe here, this is a view basic information about your computer. So what is the operating system installed in the your computer, that is a Windows 10 Pro, and the processor, it's an Intel Core i3. So this is the processor in our system, in my laptop, so with a 1.90 GHz, and the memory RAM is 8 GB RAM, and among these 8 GB, 7.9 GB is usable. And the architecture of this operating system, there is a 64-bit operating system. And pen and touch, so is any pen and touch is embedded in our to our laptop. So here you can find no pen or touch input is available for this display, so there is no external device installed. And here the computer name and the work group and all these things will be available in this screen. And if you go to the device manager, so left hand side you can see the menu, go with the device manager, you can find all the devices of your laptop or a desktop in this place. So you can find the audio inputs and outputs. So it is a tree like structure, so just click on the arrow mark, so it will be expanding, right? So the battery, regarding the battery, and Bluetooth, what is the version of this Bluetooth, and the disk drives, the display adapters, okay, graphic display, the DVD and the IDEs, and all the keyboard, right? The keyboard, mouse, monitors, network adapters, so everything. So whatever the device available in our laptop, the information of all the devices will be managed in here itself. That is a device manager. Okay, you can see the processor. See, Intel i3 processor, 1.90 GHz, right? So like this, each and everything will be available at this place. That is a device manager. The name itself indicates all the devices available in our laptop will be managed here. Right, so this is the place where we can find the device. So this is how we can check the configuration in our laptop, right? So hope you understood, and if you are having any doubts regarding this one, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. Definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my session, like my session, share my session with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Thank you very much.